Hello friends, welcome back to Engineering Nature. I hope you will be healthy and happy. So once again we are coming with one more tutorial based on interface modeling to simulate interface. Here we are considering a flow of air and water through mini size of channel. This one is the similar geometry which I had considered in my one of the previous tutorial of hot and cold water mixing which involved heat transfer. For geometry and mesh creation you can visit that tutorial. I will provide the link in my description box. The objective of today's tutorial is to simulate air and water flow through mini channel which had a diameter of 2 mm. We are trying to capture the interface between air and water with the help of volume of fluid model. I will also demonstrate the unique non-iterative method which will reduce significant computational time. At the same time, we also capture the animation of bubble breakup. So let's start. Once you import the geometry in Fluent, you should ensure the dimensions should be in millimeter scale. After that you can check the mesh. Once the mesh check has been done, in the display you can see where I had defined air inlet and where I had defined the water inlet. We are going to use pressure based transient solver. We are also considering the gravity effect. Now in the model sections, since it is a air water multiphase problem, so to capture the interface, the volume of fluid model is the best suited model for this type of problem. We also required to capture sharp interface, as well as we also considered the body force. Once you apply this physics, we should also define the primary as well as secondary phase in the phase segment. Before that, you should include the material, go to the material segment and add the fluid which you want to supply through this mini channel. By default, we have air. From Fluent database, you can add the whichever fluid you want to supply, whichever another fluid you want to supply. So I'm considering water liquid over here. You add water liquid from Fluent database, and then after in the phase segment you can define the primary and secondary phase. Now in the phase interaction sections, we have to make interaction between water and air via surface tension. We are only considering the surface tension interactions. There is no other mechanism for slug flow. Once you define the physics, let's define the viscous model. We are considering the simple K epsilon standard model. Now you just close that tab. We already defined the material. In the seal zone conditions, you can also include the via operating condition, you can also include the gravity effect through this option also. Now let's define the inlet boundary conditions. We have to define air inlet as well as water inlet boundary condition. We are incorporating air velocity and water velocity at the inlet. So I am considering 0.2 meter per second of air velocity through the inlet sections. At the same time, we should define the intensity, turbulent intensity, as well as hydraulic diameter in that boundary conditions. Now one more thing you should carefully provide, that is the volume fraction of air at the air inlet section should be 1. So go to the phase added section. From the air phase, you just incorporate volume fraction as a 1. In the similar way, let's define the water inlet velocity. So from the water inlet, the water will supply at the velocity of 0.1 meter per second. The similar turbulent intensity and hydraulic diameter you should incorporate. At the same time, here also we have to incorporate the volume fraction volume fraction of air that should be zero at the water inlet section. So go to the phase, select the air, and with the edit options you can incorporate the volume fraction of zero at the water inlet. This is very much important in this air water slug flow simulations. Now at the outlet, we are considering, for the mixture we are considering pressure outlet boundary conditions. You just apply zero gauge pressure and corresponding turbulent intensity and hydraulic diameter will be similar. Now one more important thing is, in the wall boundary conditions we are considering stationary wall as well as no slip conditions. The most important thing is you have to define wall adhesion property between air and water. That can be defined by mean of contact angle. So here we are considering 60 degree of contact angle, which will decide the shape of the slug bubble. Now once you define the boundary condition, we close that tab and let's go to the solution setting. Now in the solution setting, we are considering piezo scheme for pressure velocity coupling, as well as we are considering second order momentum. Now most important thing is we are enabling this option that is called as a NITA scheme, non-iterative time advancement. Once you enable that, it tremendously reduces the iteration time and there is no need to define residual for this particular scheme. So now once all setup has been done, you just initialize the problem. Generally we are prefer the hybrid initializations. Once you do the initialization, you can also go to the calculation activity and save your animation file by this particular options. You should also incorporate the number after which the file will be saved, and ultimately that file will utilize to generate that animations. Now once everything has been set, you just start the calculations. In the calculation tab, you should choose the appropriate time step size. Currently I am considering 1 microsecond for smooth conversion, as well as 6 intermediate intervals. And once you fixed that all, you start your calculations. Here I already calculated up to almost 32,000 iterations. The interface capturing is always time consuming problem. I already run this calculation from last couple of days. After that, this number of files which I had saved in my particular folders, which will create the nice animations. In this situation, this NITA scheme will save considerable time. So after more than 30,000 iterations, I have almost 700 frames through which we are in the position to create nice bubble formation animations. Now once you create these animations, you can also write this file, and that file animation video will be saved in MPEG format in your desired folder location, where you have plenty of animation files which shown over here. Now let me show you the contours. Go to the contours, select the face contour, where you should select the volume fraction of air. This 0 indicating there is no air, that means it's water, and 1 indicating there is completely air bubbles which will create. Likewise here, three air bubbles has been created. These three bubbles have wall contact angle of 60 degree. So that's it for today. You can kindly subscribe and press bell icon to getting such type of more videos on ANSYS-Fluent. So goodbye, take care. Let's enjoy the animations. Thank you.